Dietary fiber is a mixture of complex organic substances, including hydrophilic compounds, such as soluble and insoluble polysaccharides and non-digestible oligosaccharides, as well as a range of less hydrophobic compounds, such as chitins, submarins, and lignins. In this video, we describe the Lee method, AOAC method 991.43, for the separate measurement of high molecular weight dietary fiber into insoluble dietary fiber, IDF, and SDFP, which is soluble polysaccharides that precipitate from solution in 80% ethanol. The Lee method described in this video is a modification to the Prosky method for total dietary fiber. In this modification, the enzymatic incubation conditions are simplified, as both alpha-amylase and protease incubations are performed in the same buffer, MES-TRIS. A further practical modification to the Prosky method involves the introduction of a filtration step following the enzymatic incubations, but prior to the ethanol precipitation step. This modification allows for the separation of high molecular weight dietary fiber into IDF and SDFP. Official AOAC validation for these modifications was passed in 1991, leading to AOAC method 991.43 and AACC method 3207.01. As with the Prosky method, only high molecular weight polysaccharides, including those that are water insoluble and those that precipitate from solution in 80% ethanol, are measured by the Lee method. Non-digestible oligosaccharides are not measured at all, and incorrect values are obtained for resistant starch. In many cases, the dietary fiber values obtained with the Lee method are adequate, and for this reason, the Lee method is widely used. This video tutorial will demonstrate the use of this method with various sample types along with assay blanks. The kit comes in various sizes, containing sufficient reagents for 100 or 200 assays, and is supplied with a detailed data booklet. The principle of the Lee method for the measurement of total soluble and insoluble dietary fiber is outlined in this figure. Samples are treated with a thermostable alpha-amylase for 30 minutes at 95 to 98 degrees Celsius, during which starch is hydrolyzed. Protein in the sample is hydrolyzed by the incubation with protease for 30 minutes at 60 degrees Celsius, and maltodextrins are hydrolyzed by incubation with amyloglucosidase for a further 30 minutes. This process of enzymatic incubations hydrolyzes proteins and starch from the sample, mimicking digestion. Insoluble dietary fiber, IDF, is filtered, and the residue is washed with warm distilled water. This process separates the insoluble dietary fiber from the soluble dietary fiber that is soluble in water but precipitates with 80% ethanol. Once filtered, any remaining lipids are removed from the IDF residue by solvent washing, and the residues are then dried. For soluble dietary fiber determination, the combined solution of the filtrate and water washings are precipitated with 4 volumes of 95% ethanol. The precipitate is then filtered, washed with solvents to remove any remaining lipids, and dried. Both the SDFP and the IDF residues are incubated in duplicate, and the residue weights are measured and recorded. One residue is then analysed for ash content, and the second is analysed for residual protein. Both of these weights are subtracted from residue weights to give the value for dietary fiber. Total dietary fiber is equal to the sum of IDF plus SDFP. Please see our video on the preparation of fritted crucibles with C-Lite filter beds for dietary fiber analysis. Further details on how to prepare crucibles for dietary fiber sample analysis. Mill the sample to pass a 0.5mm screen. Dietary fiber should be determined on an as-is basis on dried, fat-free samples. Dry the samples overnight in a vacuum oven at 70 degrees Celsius or in a forced air oven at 103 degrees Celsius. On removing the samples from the oven, transfer them to a desiccator and allow them to cool to room temperature. Alternatively, analyze the samples on an as-is basis and separately determine moisture content and allow for this in the final values. For samples with a fat content above 10% weight per weight, defat these with petroleum ether according to the booklet, or alternatively defat using an ANCOM XT15 extractor. Prior to sample analysis, prepare the required additional reagents as described in the kit data booklet. All kit components, α-amylase, protease and amyloglucosidase, are supplied as ready-to-use solutions. Weigh 1 gram of sample, correct to the nearest 0.1 milligram, into 250 milliliter Fisher brand glass bottles. Alternatively, 400 milliliter tall form beakers can be used. To each bottle, add a 7 by 30 millimeter stirrer bar. Add 40 milliliters of Mess Tris Blend Buffer Solution, pH 8.2, to each bottle. With each assay, two blanks should be run, along with the samples to measure any contribution from reagents to residues, and should be included in all processes. To prevent lump formation, stir on a magnetic stirrer until sample is completely dispersed in solution. Add 50 microliters of heat-stable alpha-amylase, bottle 1, while stirring at low speed. Cap the bottles and place into a water bath at 98 to 100 degrees Celsius and incubate for 30 minutes with continuous agitation. Swirl the bottle contents at 5-minute intervals over a 30-minute incubation period. Use a thermometer to check the temperature. It is essential that the contents of the bottles are at approximately 100 degrees Celsius for at least 15 minutes. Remove the bottles from the boiling water bath and place them to cool at 60 degrees Celsius. Remove the caps and scrape any residues or gels from the sides and bottom of the bottles with a spatula. Rinse the side walls of the bottles and spatula with 10 milliliters of distilled water. Add 100 microliters of protease solution, bottle 2, to each sample. Start the timer when the temperature of the water bath reaches 60 degrees Celsius. Cap the bottles and incubate in a stirring water bath at 60 degrees Celsius plus or minus 1 degree, with continuous agitation for 30 minutes. Alternatively, incubate the bottles in a shaking water bath set in orbital motion at 60 degrees Celsius. Adjust the pH of the solutions to 4.1 to 4.8. by adding 5 milliliters of 0.561 normality hydrochloric acid to each bottle. If pH adjustment is required, adjust the pH of the solutions with a 5% sodium hydroxide solution or a 5% hydrochloric acid solution. Incubate the bottles in a stirring water bath at 60 degrees Celsius. Add 200 microliters of amyloglucosidase solution, bottle 3, while stirring on a magnetic stirrer. Replace the lids. Incubate in a stirring water bath at 60 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes, with constant agitation. Start timing when the temperature of the water bath reaches 60 degrees Celsius. Alternatively, incubate the bottles in a shaken water bath set in orbital motion at 60 degrees Celsius. To each sample, add 4 volumes of 95% ethanol, which has been measured at room temperature and subsequently preheated to 60 degrees Celsius. Cap all samples and mix thoroughly. Allow the precipitate to form at room temperature for 60 minutes. Weigh the crucibles containing the zeolite to the nearest 0.1 mg on an analytical balance. Wet and redistribute the zeolite in the crucible using approximately 15 milliliters of 78% volume per volume ethanol from a wash bottle over a Büttner flask labeled as waste. Apply suction to distribute the zeolite as an even mat on the crucible. Do this for each crucible. Transfer the crucible from the waste Büttner to the sample Büttner and apply a vacuum to the flask. Decant some of the supernatant solution from the sample into a beaker, then apply the rest of the precipitated TDF suspension to the crucible. Use the decanted solution to rinse any remaining sample from the sample bottle and use the rubber policeman spatula to dislodge sample from the sides of the incubation bottle. Apply this solution to the crucible. Filter the suspension under vacuum and recover the TDF residue in the crucible. Using a wash bottle with 78% ethanol and a rubber spatula, quantitatively transfer all remaining particles to the crucible. Transfer the crucible back to the waste collection Büttner flask. Wash the sample with 2 15 ml portions of 78% ethanol or IMS, 2 15 ml portions of 95% ethanol or IMS, and finally with 2 15 ml portions of acetone. Leave the samples on the Büttner until the smell of acetone can no longer be detected in the residues. Loosely cover the crucibles containing the TDF residue with aluminium foil and dry these at 105 degrees Celsius overnight in a hot air oven. Transfer the crucibles from the oven to a desiccator and allow it to cool over 1 hour. Weigh the crucibles containing dietary fiber residue plus zeolite, correct to the nearest 0.1 mg, and record this weight. Use this weight to calculate residue mass by subtracting the tear weight. Tear weight is the weight of the dried crucible plus zeolite only. One residue from each type of fibre is analysed for protein, and the second residue of the duplicate is analysed for ash. Determine protein and ash weight in grams. Protein analysis is performed using Keldahl or combustion methods. Ash analysis is determined by incinerating the second residue for 5 hours at 525 degrees Celsius. This residue weight is corrected for protein, ash, and the blank value for the final calculation of TDF as high molecular weight dietary fiber. Weigh the crucibles containing the zeolite to the nearest 0.1 mg on an analytical balance. Wet and redistribute the zeolite in the crucible using approximately 15 milliliters of 78% volume-per-volume ethanol from a wash bottle over a Büttner flask labelled as waste. Apply suction to distribute the zeolite as an even mat on the crucible. Do this for each crucible. Transfer the crucible from the waste Büttner to the sample Büttner, which is labelled according to the sample, and apply a vacuum to the flask. Apply the sample to the crucible. Using a wash bottle with 70 degrees Celsius deionized water, rinse the incubation bottle with approximately 10 milliliters of water. Use the rubber policeman spatula to dislodge any remaining sample from the sides of the incubation bottle. Apply this solution to the crucible. Rinse the incubation bottle with a further 10 milliliters of deionized water at 70 degrees Celsius and again transfer to the crucible. IDF is retained in the crucible. Retain the combined filtrate and washings for the determination of SDFP. Transfer to a pre-tiered 600 milliliter tall form beaker. Transfer the crucible back to the waste Büttner and wash the sample with two 10 milliliter portions of 95% ethanol or IMS. And finally with two 10 milliliter portions of acetone. Leave the samples on the Büttner until the smell of acetone can no longer be detected in the residues. Loosely cover the crucibles containing the IDF residue with aluminium foil and dry these at 105 degrees Celsius overnight in a hot air oven. Transfer the crucibles from the oven to a desiccator and allow it to cool over 1 hour. Weigh the crucibles containing the IDF residue plus zeolite, correct to the nearest 0.1 mg, and record this weight. Use this weight to calculate the residue mass by subtracting the tear weight, which is the weight of the dried crucible plus zeolite only. One residue from each type of fibre is analysed for protein and the second residue of the duplicate is analysed for ash. Determine protein and ash weight in grams as previously described. This residue weight is corrected for protein, ash and the blank value for the final calculation of IDF. Record the weight of the retained combined filtrate and washings from the IDF filtration, which has been transferred into a pre-tiered tall form 600 ml beaker. Preheat the retained filtrate of each sample to 60 degrees Celsius. Also preheat 4 volumes of 95% ethanol or IMS, which has been measured at room temperature, to 60 degrees Celsius. Use a portion of the pre-warmed ethanol to rinse the filtering Büttner flask. Add the 4 volumes of preheated 95% ethanol to the sample beaker. Mix thoroughly with the spatula and cover with aluminium foil. Allow the precipitate to form at room temperature for 60 minutes prior to filtration. However, if required from a time standpoint, it can be left to sit overnight. After 60 minutes, filter and wash the suspension and recover the SDFP fraction on the sintered glass funnel as described for the recovery of TDF and as summarised here. The calculations of dietary fibre and or the separate components can be performed as detailed in the kit data booklet. The calculations can also be significantly simplified using the Excel-based MegaCalc application specific to this total dietary fibre assay kit, which is available to download free of charge from the Megazyme website. The MegaCalc spreadsheet provides full instructions for use. Open the MegaCalc worksheet and input the following. Sample details. Insert the sample identifier. Insert the recorded sample weight in grams, correct to the nearest 0.1 mg. Insert the residue weight R1 and R2 for the sample and the blank BR1 and BR2. Residue mass is calculated by subtracting the crucible plus sea light tear weight from the dried and cooled crucible containing dietary fiber residue plus sea light. Insert the protein weight P for the sample and blank BP in grams. Insert the ash mass A for the sample and blank BA in grams. When this data is entered, the content of dietary fiber in the sample is automatically calculated and given as percent weight per weight. Individual dietary fiber components IDF and SDFP are also calculated as described. Further information on the importance of enzyme purity for the measurement of dietary fiber is discussed in detail in a paper by McCleary. Information on the collaborative study for this method is available from the AOAC.